In the aftermath of Hurricane Harvey, tens of thousands of cars were flooded in the Houston area. Now, some of them may be coming our way, ending up right here in the tri-state on used car lots. Consumer reporter John Matarese puts you to the test to see if you know the warning signs of a flood-damaged used car so you don't waste your money.
Imagine buying a used car, then discovering later that it's rusting out and that the electronics are fritzing out. Well, that's what happens if you buy a flood-damaged car. So take our test and see if you can tell if a car has been flooded.
Tens of thousands of cars underwater in Houston this summer. Most are now being sold as junk for parts, but not all of them.
We're going to give it a shot.
Gary Turner was the first to take our flood car challenge. With the help of Carfax, we set up three used Ford Focuses outside Jungle Jim's International Market. Two were clean, courtesy the Automotive Connection of Fairfield, but one of them had been flooded by Hurricane Harvey.
I don't think this one was in the flood. I'll say this one.
You're guessing red, huh?
I'm guessing red.
Gary was wrong.
It proves that you can't judge a book by its cover.
Chris Basso of Carfax says unscrupulous sellers will shine them up and sell them as good used cars.
Flooded cars literally rot from the inside out, but cosmetically they can look like any used car that's on the road.
How tough is it for the average person to spot a flood-damaged car?
The majority of consumers don't know what to look for and haven't done the proper research.
Connie Listerman and her daughter, Brianna, gave it a try too.
I'm gonna lay down.
They even looked under the cars. Their final guess?
Which one was in a flood?
I think this one. This is my guess.
Mine was the red.
Mom Connie was wrong. Daughter Brianna got it right.
You know, no matter how well cleaned up a flood car might be, if you look deep enough in the trunk and the engine compartment, you're gonna find a little dirt and sand, like right here, right here.
So Chris shared with us the red flags a used car might have been underwater. Red flag number one, sand or dirt where it shouldn't be.
So we want to pop the trunk.
Such as under the spare tire.
You want to look for mud, some condensation, water.
Red flag number two, a musty odor.
There's a musty, moldy smell to this vehicle.
Red flag number three, rust on the seat hardware.
There's rust on the seat bolts.
And red flag number four, moisture in the taillights.
Here you can see inside the taillights, there's water and condensation.
You probably didn't think of that. I didn't either. Yep, I took the test and was wrong too.
All three of you guys are wrong.
So how can you protect yourself? Well, a Carfax report should show if the car had been flooded, while the title will show where it had been registered. If it comes up Houston, be suspicious. You don't waste your money. I'm John Matarese, 9 on your side.